ring out of Auckland, New Zealand, by way of Lagos, Nigeria, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world, Israel, the last style bender, Adesanya!
Everyone has a champion inside of them, but some people seem to be born with that mindset and discipline which elevates them to the next level. One such champion with great promise is Israel Stylebender Adesanya, who is a Nigerian-born professional mixed martial artist. He's also a former kickboxer and boxer. As a mixed martial artist, this 6'4" genius is currently signed to the Ultimate Fighting Championship, where he's the UFC middleweight champion and has a record of 20-1. In kickboxing, he is a former Glory middleweight championship title challenger. As of March 30th, 2021, he ranks number 5 in the UFC men's pound-for-pound list. Adesanya is widely regarded as one of the best strikers in the world of mixed martial arts. Now, why do we say he has the mindset of a champion? And what are the qualities that he has that should inspire us? Well, let's dive in and find out. Number 8, his origin story. Adesanya was born in Lagos and was the eldest of his 5 siblings. He enrolled in Taekwondo classes and did really well until he had to leave because of an injury. The whole family then moved to Ghana for 10 months. His schooling there changed his life. He was a quiet boy, interested in anime like Death Note and Naruto, and didn't like sports much. He was bullied a lot at Rotorua Boys High School, and that led him to pick up martial arts in the future to keep the bullies at bay. At 18, he started his training in kickboxing and got off to a quick 8-0 start. This spurred him to go professional, and at 21, when he moved to Australia, he trained with future UFC fighters like Dan Hooker, Volkanovski, and Cara France. This paved the way for him to become a seasoned fighter and build on his strong mindset. Number 7, his stellar professional fighting history. His professional MMA debut was in 2012 against James Griffith, where he won via TKO, and he repeated the same with his next fight against John Vaque. But after that, he took a 2-year hiatus from MMA, and in 2015, he had a comeback fight against Chinese fighter Song Kainan. He won that fight with a head kick to Song and finished him off with ground and pound. He scored an 8-0 record and won the AFC Middleweight Championship in Australia with a first-round TKO against Melvin Gillard. With no losses, Adesanya's record seems to be clean. He showed a lot of talent, and people were obviously curious as to where and how he's going to end up. Number 6, UFC contracts and fights. He signed a contract with the UFC in December 2017, and his debut was against Rob Wilkinson in UFC 221. He won the second fight by TKO, and this got him the performance of the night bonus. He won his next match with Marvin Vettori by a split decision. His next opponent was Brad Tavares on 6th of July 2018 in the UFC finale. He won unanimously, and he yet again obtained the Performance of the Night award. Again in UFC 230, he won against Derek Brunson via TKO. This earned him his 3rd Performance of the Night award. He also went on to win against Anderson Silva, who was the former UFC middleweight champion, and both of them got the Fight of the Night award. In his bout against Silva, his childhood hero, he showed a lot of poise and mental toughness. Even though Silva may have been nearing the end of his fight career, he's still regarded as one of the most dangerous fighters in the cage. Number 5, his professional kickboxing career. He's been the contender to being a champion since his early days. In 2010, Adesanya defeated Tim Antonio unanimously. He won the next 6 fights and got a place in the 2014 Kunlun Fight 2 and also made a Glory debut at Glory 15 and lost to Ver Lindon. But 3 months later, Adesanya got his revenge at Glory of Heroes 3. He even participated in King in the Ring Cruiserweights 2 tournament and took home the gold. What a great bounce back. Number 4, his winning of the UFC middleweight champion title. After defeating the former UFC champ Silva, his next fight was for the interim middleweight belt. He faced Kelvin Gastelum in the championship in 2019 and won by unanimous decision after 5 rounds. It was a back-and-forth match and the audience was excited. This earned him the Performance of the Night award and was regarded as the best fight of the year, and the MMA media were in a frenzy about it for months. His next opponent was Robert Whittaker at UFC 243, and again he won by knockout, getting him his fourth Performance of the Night award. He seemed to be on his way up, and the fights were just going to get tougher from here. He had to face Yoel Romero in UFC 248. Romero is a three-time UFC title challenger, and Adesanya still came out on top. However, for all the hype the previous matches had, this seemed to fall short of the action and adrenaline, and fans were quick to point this out. There was no significant offense, and at no point were fans oohing and aahing. As boring as the fight was to watch, his mindset was strong and confident, he kept to his game plan, and he got the W. The next title defense was epic. It was against Paulo Costa at UFC 253, and both had a history of being unbeaten until that date. This was a groundbreaking match, as there was a lot of bad blood and trash talking back and forth. With all of this, Adesanya came out on top with flying colors. He chopped down Costa with deadly leg kicks before ending him with vicious ground and pound. The champ looked great and executed his game plan to perfection. He had a lot of time in the sun and blazed strongly. However, when he faced Jan Blachowicz in 2021 for a light heavyweight UFC, he lost. This was the first time he was defeated in his MMA career. He did go up a weight class, and the undersized Adesanya had a tough time with the bigger Blachowicz in the later rounds. Jan played a great game with taking Adesanya down and staying on top of him in a dominant position. You think the stylebender has what it takes to bounce back even stronger? Number 3, his professional boxing career. Adesanya started his professional boxing career in November 2014 against the two-time Australian champion Daniel Amon. The event was so popular because of the appearance of Shane Cameron and Callie Meehan at the North Shore Events Center in Auckland, New Zealand. He suffered a controversial loss via unanimous decision after he looked to have outscored Amon in the quarterfinals. This miffed fans a lot, and this fight has many mixed reviews. This didn't stop Adesanya. On March 8, 2015, he entered the Super 8 boxing tournament held in New Zealand. This was the second cruiserweight series where the winner was going to get 25,000 New Zealand dollars and a new car. In the first round of the tournament, he won against fellow New Zealander Asher Derbyshire by KO. In the second fight of the tournament, Adesanya won by a majority decision against Lance Bryant. In the tournament finale, he faced off against Brian Minto, where he won the tournament via split decision. He's got the temperament of a champion for sure. This is Israel Adesanya, and he's unstoppable. Having to have three fights in a night will strengthen any fighter's mind. Adesanya stayed focused and always kept his eye on the prize. Number 2, something different in his personal life. Adesanya is a man with many talents. Before taking up fighting, Adesanya regularly used to compete in dance competitions across New Zealand. He showcased his passion for dance in a choreographed walkout at UFC 243, which was never heard of before. He's a hardcore fan of anime too, and it is his dream to start an anime production company after retiring from fighting. His nickname, The Last Stylebender, is a reference to Avatar: The Last Airbender, an anime-influenced cartoon series. He loves the show so much that Adesanya has the image of one of the show's main characters, Toph Beifong, tattooed on his forearm. This must be a cool side to have. Having a side passion is important because it doesn't let you forget who you are or what your goals are. Number 1, accolades and accomplishments. He won the UFC middleweight championships and has maintained two successful title defenses, and he's won the interim UFC middleweight championship. Don't forget the 5 Performance of the Night awards. He's got the Fight of the Night, and he's won the award for the most knockdowns in a UFC title fight. He was the AFC middleweight champion and also won Fighter of the Year in 2019. The Wrestling Observer also crowned him as Most Outstanding Fighter of the Year in 2019 and 2020. What a stud! Raw talent can only take you so far. All these accolades and accomplishments are a testament to how strong-minded and strong-willed this champion truly is. He's still got much more potential, and we can't wait to see what the future holds for him. He's got the gravitas of a champion, and we think he's got the mindset and determination for it. We're looking to see him in winning shape with his next bounce-back fight. So, that was all about Israel Adesanya. What do you think about him? Does he have the mental toughness to bounce back from the loss to Blachowicz? Will this be his downfall? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more MMA content. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye.
Whoever said the sky's the limit doesn't know about the universe.